cancer. It's responsible for one in every seven human deaths. We spend billions of dollars researching it year in and year out, trying to understand and treat it. But our success in these endeavors continues to be greatly limited. So why is this? Well, cancer is really just an umbrella term for an incredibly large family of diseases. Tumors vary not only based on their locations within our bodies, but also from patient to patient. If we're going to successfully treat these tumors, we have to account for this biological variability. We'll be focusing on the tumor vasculature. This is the delivery network which supplies the tumor with oxygen, nutrients, and drugs. Now, it's governed by what are known as angiogenic factors. Angio meaning vessel, and genic like genesis being to form or create. In our healthy normal tissues, we have a good balance between the pro and the anti-angiogenic factors. And this balance leads to a well-structured vasculature. But in tumors, this balance is thrown out. We have an excess of the pro-angiogenic factors leading to a chaotic formation of vasculature. The vessels formed are abnormal. They're tortuous, leaky, and in general just very inefficient despite the great quantity present. We could try and get rid of all this vasculature, but not only is that likely to affect our healthy tissue as well, but we're going to need this delivery system in place for our later treatment strategies. Chemotherapy, for example, relies on transport of drugs to the tumor through this vasculature, and radiation therapy relies on an oxygen supply being at the tumor site. So rather what we want to do is try and normalize this vasculature, returning it to a well-structured state by balancing out those angiogenic factors. And we can do this by providing a patient with what are known as anti-angiogenic drugs. But how do we know how much drugs to give them, and how will this affect our treatment strategies down the line? Well, that's where our model comes in. Our model is the very first in the world to be able to take an individual patient data, such as PET scans and CT scans, and use these to generate a simulation of their tumor vasculature based on that individual patient. Incorporating biology, computer science, mathematics, and physics, we can then evolve this tumor and see what it might look like 2 weeks from now, based on various possibilities of treatment with angiogenic drugs. And this is just the beginning. From there, in the future, our model will be able to explore every possible scenario of chemotherapy or radiation therapy to be able to determine the most optimal situation and the best outcome for the patient. It's estimated that a third of you here today will develop cancer at some point in your lives. But models like ours give hope. Hope that if this were to happen to you, you will receive the most optimal combination of treatment strategies possible, based on your specific circumstances. Models like ours really are ensuring that in the future, every patient will have the best chance of beating their tumor. Thank you.